Hello everyone, this is Mesolite Visual. The process of carrying out project in ArchiCAD is frustrating most of the time due to the limitations we encounter as users of the softwares. But there are a lot of hidden features that you need to unlock to enjoy the best practice doing your projects. This tutorial is from our Virtual Design and Construction ArchiCAD Simplified course. The course is a practical demonstration of constructing the project from start to finish with every step thoroughly explained. It comprises of 5 series: site work and excavation, foundation, walls and columns, superstructure construction, roof structure construction, curtain wall and civil works, curtain wall schedules and details. The last but not least, quantities. This course is for you to carry out projects from design to construction utilizing the best and easy practice workflows. At the end of the course, you will be able to use the power of computing to design, manage, and construct your project at a high level of accuracy. Instruct and let the software do the most of the work for you and simplify your workflow. Do you want to produce high-quality drawing in less time effortlessly? Take control and manage project well. Be efficient and productive. Be confident with your quality of work. Attract more clients due to easy and simple workflow of project. Enroll now with VDC ArchiCAD Made Simple and hit subscribe button. Activate floor plan view. Go to curtain wall tool. Pick the first point to install the wall, then finish by clicking the second point. Activate elevation window. Select the curtain wall, then edit. From the edit curtain wall window, select scheme grid. Then click on the top midpoint of the grid to add a point. Pick the top corner and define the shape of the structure. Do the same to the other points. Select top horizontal member and delete to reduce the number of panels. Click on the bottom grid line, then move it up to increase the height or resize the panels. Select the distinct panels and change it to main panel. Then exit the edit mode and check the result in 3D window. Activate plan view to add another curtain wall. It is pretty easy. Make sure it's installed well in the opening by stretching the points. Check on the 3D window. Open elevation window and select the curtain wall. Then edit, select scheme grid and pick the top part of the grid and offset edge to the position. Reduce the number of panels by deleting the horizontal members. Click on the grids line to adjust the sizes of panels. Drag or mirror a copy since they are the same and adjust the length to fit. Activate the floor plan view and copy the curtain wall to the opening, then adjust to fit in the opening. Check 3D window. Open the elevation to modify it. Select then edit. Select scheme grid and offset the top part to the height of the opening. Adjust the size of the middle panel to fit the door size. Select the panel and change the panel to any door type. Select the door and open the door settings. Then adjust the frame sizes and handle. Check the result in 3D window. Adjust the height of the door by offsetting the transom grid. Then delete the transom member. Activate side plan view and duplicate the floor slab and offset the copy with 1.2 and subtract it from the original slab. Mark you to cut the driveway paving and 3D window mark you. Then select the paving and change the attributes to 100. thick 25 MPa compaction. Open the site plan and activate the wall tool and load RC wall culvert. Then draw the capstones for the driveway. Activate 3D window and adjust the height to 150 and position it to the top of the paving and change the material to concrete precast. Then flip it to the inside. Select it and go to complex profiles and capture the profile. Modify the profile to a capstone and save a profile. Make sure you mirror it and then apply to the cabins. Go back to profile window and adjust the height to 20. Then save. This is a perfect connection. Let's construct culvert for stormwater drainage. Pick parameters of the culvert wall and draw a wall on the edge of the plot. Inject parameters. Do the same to the other side. Select the terrain, then connect solid element operation and subtract the walls from the terrain. Activate the site plan view and draw the wall to the edge of the road for both sides. Appreciate in 3D window. Pick parameters of paving slab and open settings to override surfaces. Then draw the slab base of the drainage system. 3D window to adjust the position. Adjust the walls by the entrance to allow water to pass underneath the bridge slab for both sides. Cut a section across the trench and open the view to adjust the wall to the base. Go back to the plan view and stretch to extend the drainage along the road for both sides. Go and select the walls and duplicate to the top and change the height to 100. The thickness to 115. Move it down to flush with top of the drainage wall. Use solid element operations. Select the 100 by 115 as operator and the wall as a target. Then subtract with upward extrusion. Select the piece and put under hidden layer. Duplicate the wall and pick parameters of the previous operation and inject to the copy. Flip it to the inside. Perform solid element operation to subtract. Then select the two and hide a layer. Go to plan view to add the concrete cap to close up the drainage trench. Activate slab tool and change the height to 150 and material to precast concrete. Then draw the block. 3D window to adjust the length to fit to the rebase we just created. Multiply with spacing of 50 for expansion joints. Adjust the last two blocks to fit perfect to close the trench. It's perfect. Go ahead and complete the remaining side. Go to site plan view and activate line 2. Then divide the road into half. Select the road and add points in the edge midpoint. Activate 3D window and pick the midpoint of the road. Then select elevate 2 from the pad palette to elevate the height of the point by 100. And do the same for the other side. Activate floor plan. Go to slab 2 and change the material to road. Then draw a 500 by 100 block on the road mark. Position it in the middle of the road and move it top surface. Multiply the block spacing by 3.5 or 3 meters along the length of the road. Thank you guys. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and like, share, comment. Cheers.